Is it recording now?
Indubitably, my good man.
Alright, I'm gonna do the same thing.
You're really sick.
I'm gonna do the same thing that you guys have been doing, so I'm gonna need a place and a person and an object. The clown?
The clown
will not bite me at the basement!
The basement! And for an object,
there are many
Jim's hat.
People who live in basements.
Jim's hat is the object.
Lucky hat, who I punch people for taking.
I was planning on putting Jim in the story.
That should be an action movie. Someone takes Jim's hat.
Story.
Taken part two.
I'm gonna Taken. I was gonna say.
I'm gonna try to write something like that. Someone takes Jim's hat and he goes insane.
Not like Jeff
back.
Now here's the commercial. Jim punches him in the face. I want my hat back. What are you talking about? Then it's like they cut to like the words. One man. Jim with an AK.
A hat.
The slow motion jump from
a computer life. Just lots of undrank milk. And what the hell do you get? I'm not answering that.
No, it's just a picture of Jim slapping someone. Why are you hitting yourself?
Alright, ready?
Go on, tell the story.
Alright, so, for seemingly no reason whatsoever, Jim was dressed up in a clown suit in his basement. No one knew why he was down there.
Well, Jim, you are kinky.
His parents believed he was setting up for the next movie night.
What? Is he the show or
But little did they know that he was actually creating more milk to put in the fridge for his brother to drink.
Milk raisin milk.
Alright, then I need another person.
Cameron.
Me!
Then Steve came down the stairs and he looked in
front of him. Can I get out? I don't want to see that. Please.
And he called down, "Hey Jim, are you down here?" And Jim's like, "Can you please wait a minute?" So Jim quickly takes off the clown clothes, but he forgets to put...
Whoa! Ew! I want to see him naked!
He's not naked.
He's wearing normal street clothes under it.
Yes, he is. Thank you. But he forgot to take off the clown nose, so he goes upstairs, and he's like... And Steve's like,
honk.
And Jim's like, "I'm sorry. You weren't supposed to see that. Hey, Jim, I'm Steve, I have snacks!" And then,
no, it would have been more like, "Steve, I have guitar
hey,
rope!"
Hey, Steve, I have...
My love!
Hey, Steve,
why
I have...
Why is
there
an me voice?
There's no
me voice. Why you need some more sleep?
Why do you use the me voice for so many things?
I don't know.
Like, why do you use
it's
the me voice?
It's the best voice!
Could we stop associating it with me if you got used for so many things?
Whenever someone has to love something, it's Nate.
Why Nate?
Exactly.
He's like the little child in all the stories. He's bringing.
Damn, peace. I was like 3 inches off.
He's like the innocence in all the stories.
Damn.
You're so innocent.
Except he was the jobless bum who shot people.
Go on, we're overanalyzing this, go.
So Jim's like, "Hey, I have some guitar hero and candy in my van out front, so do you want to go
play?" I don't want to get raped by Jim!
And then Steve said, "But I'd love to get raped by those guitars."
This story is too scary.
So they both went into the van, and Jim drove off, and he locked the back of the van.
I regret this decision! He said that at the back of the van.
But Steven was happy, because the guitar...
Steven was back, trying to beat the high score for the help.
Please tell me I don't drink any milk.
No, you drink some coffee. Yet.
Steven was playing Guitar Hero. Wow.
Quotations. And then all of a sudden, this car stops very suddenly because there's a little Nene walking along the road.
With the hey Nene.
Wait, hello there, man with the strange car. Do you have candy? I smell candy. Do you have chocolate raisins? Can I have some chocolate raisins? Jim ran
home
because he was so annoying.
I have a question. Was there? Did she stop because she saw the sign? Like, why did I say she? He saw the sign that had like the little boy with the ball bouncing in the street, but it looked like Nate because it had his smile and his glasses and everything. Watch out for
Wow.
Oh, I heard a crack.
It's Nathan Crossing.
Watch out for rumpy names.
I hit Steve and I just heard a snap sound.
You hit my rib.
So oh, then, I didn't break it.
So then after he ran over Nathan, he was like, haha, and then an ostrich landed
he
on top
of him. He ran over? I thought he stopped.
I'm in the wrong story.
He stopped and I'm dead.
Oh, he didn't listen to the last part.
Did Nate do the deer in the headlights thing?
He didn't listen to the last part. I said he asked if he had chocolate raisins, and Jim found him annoying, so he ran him over and killed him.
Like, while he was standing in front of the car, right?
Yep.
Hey, mister! Mister, can you see me?
Do you have chocolate raisins? I smell chocolate!
I want ice cream!
Are they in there? Ice cream!
Did somebody say ice cream?
Ow.
If one of my coworkers dies that way, I've got to tell you, because every time an ice cream truck comes into the lot, he runs up to it, ice cream! If my coworker dies that way, I'm going to tell you guys.
And then Nate went into a river.
Butt cramps!
And so then an ostrich landed on top of the van. It says, you can't do that. You murdered a civilian. An innocent civilian at that. So Jim said,
it isn't
quick, my evil
shotgun.
British doppelganger. Attack. And then British Jim popped out of the driver's seat because...
I'm trying to imagine this. Like,
I have arrived.
And use his airbending monocle to blow the ostrich away. And because the ostrich could not fly, he just
squinted really hard.
So then the ostrich
feed me.
So then the ostrich,
watch me break wind.
So then British Jim pulled out an ice sword, was like, wait, where did
Connor
get this?
But then Connor took it and played with
it. I like ice.
And then he drinks.
He's not Nathan! He might be related to
and
Nathan.
Then
I like ice!
And then, that was bad. And then,
look at the Connor
move. Is that better?
I like ice!
And then Connor, unable to keep his hands off of other people's things, had some milk from Jim's house.
No, this got into a pedophile story.
Amber,
I just had an idea.
Oh no.
You know that scene from Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends where Cheese is next to Eduardo and he says, I like chocolate milk. I like potatoes.
Chocolate
milk. I can just imagine.
I got a bad idea from that.
Instead, we have Nathan sitting down and Connor walks over. I like ice! And I like
chocolate raisins.
I like ice!
I like chocolate raisins. Durr,
and I like chocolate raisins.
Oh, go ahead. I did.
That's
chocolate
all.
Milk. What is that?
Kill.
So then the ostrich went into the van and took all the chocolate raisins, and then he brought the little Nene back to life and said, here you go, little boy, all of the chocolate raisins you could ever want. He went, thanks, mister, can I ride in the car? I like Guitar Hero.
Hold on, I have a secret ending for the end of the story.
That's
that
appropriate,
I want to mention later.
Alright. What are you doing, Jim?
I have a secret ending.
Like the band for this one.
Go on, I have a secret ending.
Okay. I'm not sure. I'm trying to make this up as I go along. I'm not trying to sure what to do with this.
Don't worry.
Well, it has to involve Jim's lucky hat.
Nathan says.
Nathan says.
Hello, Mr. Ostrich. Do you have a shotgun?
And the shotgun shakes its head sadly before hopping away to go save some Natalie.
Sentient shotgun.
Before it, going to go
it
kill
popped
Natalie.
Its legs out
and
and walked off. I'm sorry, hopped off.
Hop,
hopped
off.
Hop,
yes.
Hop on pop.
Hop. So.
Pop.
So it went to go off
fish,
and kill
fish,
Natalie
fish,
because
fish,
she was
fish.
A commie. So red that. Fish. So then
shut
British
up.
Jim
Maybe
gets back in the van and they start driving, but they got lost. So they pulled over to ask Anna for directions, but British Jim accidentally called Anna Ona, and Anna got really.
Ona
angry.
Is cool.
Ona got really angry
and gave them directions
Ona won the
to the haunted
Olympics.
Graveyard.
No, Anna got really angry, so she summoned her evil British doppelganger Ona, and the evil.
Oh
British
my god! I didn't see that coming.
I did not.
And that worked.
You poor
she, dude, she got her first plot twist. I freaking love it. And it's one we never expected.
Another British doppelganger? only she were part computer.
Ooh, my.
If only she were a
cyborg.
Ooh, my.
So then the evil British doppelganger started to fight to the death, and then Jim and Thomas... Because Ona was mad at Jim, so she tried to kill Jim, but British Jim has to defend Jim.
Fatality!
No, fatality! Just throws hot tea in her face and
gets over here! Slap, slap, slap. Fatality!
So then the British doppelgangers start fighting to the death, and Jim and Ona are just standing there staring, and then Jim's like, I have candy. And then Anna's like, yes! And she jumps to the back of the van.
And they all got in his van, and then he Jim put on big glasses. Six Flags, it's playtime.
Oh, wow, that was bad. I didn't even know it.
I'm amazed they haven't been yelled at yet.
I think they're laughing as they listen.
They're like about to complain when they listen to the story and just sit down and laugh. There's like a campfire.
There's actually a whole group outside of our doorway. You're over there! Jack.
No freebies. I'm leaving this open. It's nice and cold.
Close. Turn off the light. Outside.
We can't be nameless if the light's here.
Oh.
I can't see you.
We can last. I'm just saying it's cooler out there. Go ahead.
Alright, so where was I? Oh yeah, so then... And then Otto's like, I'm sorry, I don't know where you're going. So then they look over and there's SpongeBob, Patrick, and Squidward singing the campfire song beside a campfire. And they're like, hey, do you know how to get to that place where that Jim wants to get to? And then all you hear is, C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S, and when you song, C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S, oh, that place? Yeah, just take two lefts, and then take another right, then go past the stoplight, and it's like a half mile down on the left. And then they're like, cool, thanks.
So you can spell campfire, but can you spell haruga-bliga-bliga-bliga?
There's a place that's a and then Patrick starts going, yes, this. I can. It's the Z-Z-Ogle-Zeta-4-2.
Squirrel, that's my favorite game.
And then he saw a squirrel and chased after it.
Mark Lane is even.
And Minnie Nene chased after it too.
Where the hell did he come from? Obligatory cameo. Oh, this will be perfect for my master's day gift. This is my master's favorite shape. Come back, I wish to make it. Come back, squirrel. I saw a squirrel, he was doing like this. So I shot it.
And little Nene looked on, confused, as he did not know that he was.
Was his IQ no bigger than
I was just gonna make
it. Damn it, I missed. Ball! Ball! Damn, balls. I get pushed.
So then Jim drives off without both the British doppelgangers because it's tea time, so they have to sit there and have tea for the next 15 minutes.
I don't have a crumpet, Una?
No, thank you. I prefer bagels.
Get out of my tea ceremony!
Get out of my tea ceremony!
Friends, let us all sit and have a nice tea ceremony.
Let's kill him!
And then they saw Zoidberg and were angry with him because he was not invited to the tea party, so they both simultaneously killed
British
him.
British only.
They decided to have a nice lobster bisque.
Make sure to use butter. I'm good with that.
So then...
Jesus will be mad, just saying.
So, I know that guy.
They drove to the place that SpongeBob and Patrick gave them directions to, but it turned out to be a graveyard. So they're like... Oh well, I guess.
We're sadistic. Children, watch us.
So then Jim's like, well, I guess this will work. So he starts driving through the graveyard, and then all of a sudden you see a hand pop out of the graveyard, and then a zombie hooker comes out. There's lots of
zombies. Adult Swim has really messed with you.
A zombie hooker comes out, and then people are like, wait, they still bury these people?
Yucks.
I thought they were encased in carbonite, hung from walls.
Nate, I don't think anyone get what you just said.
I think that was a Star Wars joke.
Han Solo. Well, but he wasn't a hooker or a whore. And if you say anything like that...
Nate was sexually attracted to him and wanted to pay him money for good services.
To hell with you.
So then little Nene sees it and he goes, oh, look, that person needs help.
Little Nene.
He goes up to the zombie and he's like, oh, I'll help you up, lady. You're a very nice lady, but you don't wear a lot of clothes.
No way! I remember that.
Ow, sorry.
He was like,
don't call me lady, call me mom.
Okay, lady.
Okay, lady.
we gotta make him say that from now on.
Okay, lady. I hate you so much.
Hey, buttons can be Connor.
Have any of you tried out that show Fish Hooks or something?
I don't know. I don't like it.
I've like watched one or two. You know that clam?
No.
That creepy clam girl with the hair?
Clam.
He's copying that voice.